We are live. Good afternoon, good afternoon, good evening. Good afternoon, good evening, everyone. Good afternoon, good afternoon, good evening, good evening, whatever your time zone is. Hello, hello, and welcome to Unity Fellowship Church Movement's 2020 virtual convocation. What a day! What a day this has been. We have had an awesome time. We opened up this morning with words from our House of Bishops. We attended awesome workshops, got to see each other, one another from across the nation. And now we are here to worship. And where are we? Right in your living room, in your kitchen, on your front or back porch, wherever you are, so that you can worship just as you are during this pandemic. So take a moment now, call your friends, text them. Emails them, share on Facebook and YouTube, and let them know that our worship service is about to begin. You're about to experience the wonderful word of Bishop Harris Thomas, music by our churches, just as we do at Convocation. So I know that we had some questions about what the virtual will be. Well, so far it has been amazing. And so get yourself ready, make yourself comfortable right where you are, just as you are, because this is a just as you are worship experience. And let's enter into a time of worship. So we will begin by setting the atmosphere with a worship song by one of our churches, and then we'll move on into prayer.
Praise the Lord,
for he is worthy.
For he is worthy. grace. Never will I walk tired in my place. He's worthy of all my praise. I just came to magnify. I just came to glorify. I just came to praise the Lord.
Greetings, family. Welcome to Holy Convocation, Unity Fellowship Church Movement 2020, ProAction. As we are preparing for this meditation slash prayer, I just want to encourage you that though we may not be able to be in the same physical space, that does not mean that we are not connected. I need you to hear that part really good, really clearly. That does not mean that we are not connected. Why? Because God cannot be hindered or restricted by time or space. We believe and we proclaim that God is everywhere present all the time, and that there's nowhere you can go that God is not. Also, God is a right now God. So, even as we are participating in this virtual service, we are all still connected. Secondly, as spiritual beings, we believe that God is able to give us the very desires of our hearts. I want you to hold that in your mind as we're making ourselves comfortable. Close your eyes, taking a deep breath. Be mindful that God is able to give us the very desires of our hearts. So I'm going to ask you in this moment, focus your mind on our presiding prelate, Archbishop Carl Bean, wherever he might be. And from that place of love, just radiate the very desires of your heart that we desire for him, health and long life. That we desire for him, prosperity and peace. That we desire for him, the utmost joy, because we are so grateful for his yes and for his sacrifice. That we desire for him, the very things that he desires to be comfortable in this life, that he also might attain the desires of his heart. Then hold in your awareness our leadership, our House of Bishops, and let's desire for them also continued health in their bodies. For having been so faithful thus far, let's desire for them insight, inspiration, strengthening of their voice, allowing them to be the herald of this movement, the leadership of this great movement. Then hold in your mind and your awareness the rest of our pastors and our elders and our ministers, our reverends and our deacons. and let's desire for them that they should be the front line in a time such as this, that they should understand what it means to be called the oracles of God, that they would be firm in their authentic self, confident in their calling, confident as God is speaking through them, confident as God is ushering newness and transformation and healing just from them showing up in the room. And then let's be mindful of the larger body, that we are called to be a light unto the world. We want to be committed in our relationship with God. We want to be faithful with the work that God has placed in our hands and in our care. There are so many individuals out there who need to know that message, that God is love and love is for everyone. There are so many people out there who don't even know that they're not free. There are so many out there still stuck in their pain, in their past experience, and toxic theology. Take a deep breath. Eternal Alpha and Omega, wonderful Mother, Father, Everything God, we are so thankful for this moment, realizing and celebrating that right now is all we ever really have. We thank you, O God, for this movement and all that it has done for us. We thank you, O God, for the revealed truth that has cleared a path for us, a path of liberation, of healing, of transformation. We thank you, Lord, for teaching us real love. We thank you, O God, for stretching us past our comfort zone. We thank you, O God, for calling us into this present moment. We're grateful, O God, even for our leadership and the rest of our Unity Fellowship family. In this new and different, O God, we stand in expectation that you will continue to do which you do so well, and that is be God in every aspect of our life. We stand and we sit in expectation that you will reveal yourself anew, that you would bring a word, you would speak a word into our hearts and into our spirits. We stand in expectation, O God, that you would facilitate healing, wholeness, and transformation. We stand in expectation that you would give us what it is you would have us to do in this land. Thank you, O God, for everyone that is under the sound of my voice. Their being here not being an accident, an error, or a mistake, but all part of your divine plan. Thank you, O God, for this medium that has allowed us to operate even outside of the building, outside of the confines of a facility, even outside the confines of that which we are familiar. Thank you, Lord, for being the God of the unfamiliar. We're so blessed and so grateful for all that you've done, all that you're doing in this moment, and all that you have yet to do. We will stretch ourselves out, O God, that you might expand our awareness and our consciousness. We will stretch ourselves out, O God, that you might speak a word into our hearts and our spirits. We will stretch ourselves out, that you do yet again a new thing. We declare and submit this in the name of love, in the name of Christ, in the name of all those that we call the divine. And everyone in agreement right where you're sitting, just say amen, ashe, and so it is.
Good evening, good afternoon, good day to you, wherever you are logging in from. I'm Reverend Elder Dorothy Parrish Harris, and I am here to give you an affirmation tonight. The Unity Fellowship Church movement was founded on a very seemingly simple but very powerful concept that God is love and love is for everyone. We care a great deal that you understand that you are loved just as you are, for who you are, not in spite of, but because of who you are. The psalmist, as recorded in Psalm 139 and 14, declares, I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made.
Your words are marvelous, and your works are marvelous, and I know that quite well. Fearfully, carefully, painstakingly, lovingly made. Isn't that a blessing to know that God took the time out to create you, to be this amazing, wonderful being that you are? And then you can go on to say like the psalmist and say, your works are marvelous. And you are God's work. Therefore, you are marvelous. And you need to know that quite well. So I encourage you to affirm yourself today and say, I am a wonderful work of God. God's works are marvelous, and I am God's work, and therefore I indeed am marvelous. And then I want you to affirm somebody else. Let them know that they are very special, that they are very important in the eyes of God and in your eyes. May you be blessed, may you be affirmed, and may you always know that God loves you, and so do we.
Short of the word, I've got to fast and pray. come too far, and I'll never go back, but God is.
Of my life, God rules all pain, victory is mine, promise to keep me, ever to me, ever, short of your word, I've got to ask and pray, stay in the narrow way, live my life, live every day.
God is my all in all. Promise to never leave me. Promise to keep me. God is. We might be virtual, but virtual doesn't take away from this time of worship. You know, sometimes the song hits you in a place in your heart. Well, that's all you could do is stay right there for a moment. So stay right there with me for a moment and remember, as I remember, as I hold on to, God is my all in all. God will never leave me. God promised to keep me, and God has done that. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you, Reverend. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We are moving on to the welcome, which is why I'm in the spot at this moment. But you know, sometimes spirit does what spirit does, and I couldn't move right into it. So thank you. Welcome, everyone. Welcome, Unity Fellowship Church family. Welcome all of the Unity Fellowship Church churches. Welcome to our visitors. And welcome to our friends. This is our first virtual convocation, but it is our 27th annual convocation. 27 years we have been gathering as a movement, as churches in cities across the United States, coming together in worship, in fellowship, and we continue that virtually this year, and I welcome you to it. Our church fellowships, although it's a pandemic, our churches and our fellowships are still worshiping. You can check out the various church pages and worship with them on Sundays and worship with them. Some of us have Wednesday night services. And so the churches are still working and worshiping during this pandemic. Just want to say that the Unity Fellowship Church movement, for those of you who are visiting us for the first time, who heard about us and don't really know who we are, our movement was founded over 35 years ago by Archbishop Carl Bean. And he wanted to provide a place. God gave him the strength and what he needed to develop a place for worship and to take care of God's people who were being marginalized at the time. And so we are a movement that care about all people. We don't have to name them one by one. We take care of our gay and lesbian people. We take care of our transgender family, our Black people, our white people, our straight people. All people are welcome in the Unity Fellowship Church movement. And so we invite you to continue to worship with us today. We'll be back tomorrow, Friday, for Friday evening service, as well as on Sunday. And you are welcome. Please watch our Facebook page so that you can get more information. Again, welcome one, welcome all, the Unity Fellowship Virtual Convocation, our 27th convocation, where ProAction is our theme for this year. We will now have our giving.
Good evening, good afternoon, good morning, wherever you are joining us from. We want to say welcome. Again, I want to join in the welcome of those that have gone before me in this 27th convocation, 27 years. Let's give God a hand clap praise wherever you are joining us from. I am Elder Jamie Washington. I get to serve as the senior pastor of the Unity Fellowship Church of Baltimore, and we are excited today to be with you in this ProAction convocation. You will see in a moment to go onrealm.org/UFC movement/give/offering. You're gonna see it. I'm just getting you ready for it. We are in this space where we are celebrating 27 years of convocation, celebrating 35 years in doing the work of building the kingdom of God. Our churches and fellowships are on the front lines in the environment where the realities of systemic racism are alive and well. The challenges to racism are being challenged by the highest levels of our government. We must be in ProAction. We are in a space where law enforcement and criminal justice systems are doing everything except providing justice and upholding the law. Where the economy is broken, the government is broken, we must be in ProAction. Where the country continues to discriminate and the loss of life of transgender community, women's right to choose is in jeopardy, we must be in ProAction. As you see on the line in front of you, onrealm.org/UFCM movement/give/offering. UFCM must continue to be the lightning rod for justice of hope. And so we know that ProAction requires money, talent, and time. ProAction requires money, talent, and time. I'm here tonight for the money. We can do with the talent and the time later, but we know that we must bring in the funds so that we can continue to do the business of justice. Is that all right? Somebody just clap your hands. Chat in that we are in the business of justice and that takes funds. This week, we need a proactive sacrificial offering. We need proactive sacrificial level of giving. So I am going to invite you tonight that we need to make sure that we are going to, whatever you were planning to give double. Whatever you are planning to give double. Amen. I want you to give until it hurts a little bit. That is a proactive sacrificial level of giving. We need to raise $2,000 every night. Yes, we do. To keep the ministry, the work of this ministry going. And I know it is in the Zoom. I know it is in Be Live. I know it is in the building. Some of you can give $2,000 on your own. Amen. So let the Lord, the Spirit lead you to give a proactive sacrificial level of giving. This week, we want you to proactively prioritize the movement that saved many of our lives. Is that all right? Amen. In the building, I'm inviting leaders to lead. Leaders lead in this space and time. And please, folks, don't go out of here and say, Elder Washington told me to give up my rent money. Elder Washington told me to go up here and give out my gas and electric bill. That is not what I'm saying. Pay your bills, but make a sacrificial offering to the movement that saved your life. We want to be proactive in the space tonight so that we can show up, continuing to build the kingdom, fighting for justice, living in the truth that God is love and love is for everyone. If I get 20 people to give $100, 20 people to give $100 a night, we can blow this thing up. I believe we can. I believe you will. ProAction, sacrificial offering. We believe God is going to do it right here. God bless you. What's going to happen next is you're about to hear the music.
Bread of life, sit down from glory. Let it lead you under on earth, a holy king, a carpenter.
You are the living word, Jesus.
Amen and amen and amen. We thank God for the living word of God. We are so excited tonight as we continue with our worship experience and to open our convocation experience tonight. The preacher is one who is no stranger to the movement. He is one who is no stranger to the movement. He is one who is no stranger to the ministry. We know. Amen, amen. He will bring a dynamic, open, and powerful word tonight. He is none other than the founding pastor and the presiding prelate of Jurisdiction 4. He is my friend. He is my father. He is my brother. He is my confidant. He is this movement's angel from our House of Bishops. None other than our own Bishop Harris Thomas. Let's just chat up in the chat. Just give God a hand clap praise for Bishop Harris Thomas. Amen. 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 Amen.
Praise God, praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Amen. Thank God for being here today. I give honor to God for life, for health, for strength, and all that God has done, God is doing, and God will do for me. I thank God for that. I give honor to our founding prelate, our Archbishop Carl Bing. Oh my God, so much I can say about this man because he has been a blessing, not only to me, his yes has opened so many doors. I've heard people say, just as I can say, this movement has saved my life. So I thank and praise God for you, Archbishop. Know that we are praying with you. We're praying for you. We thank God for Senior Bishop Zachary Jones and Bishop Jacqueline Holland, and all for their leadership and for just being so wonderful. I just enjoy being with them and serving in the house. Amen. We thank God for the leadership of the Unity Fellowship Church of Baltimore. We thank God, amen, for my friend. You know, he has been such a wonderful person since I have grown to love and know him personally. My pastor of the senior pastor for Unity Fellowship Church of Baltimore, none other than the elder Dr. Jamie Washington, and the first gentleman, his first gentleman, Reverend Sam Offer. We thank and praise God for you, for the leadership of Unity Fellowship Church of Baltimore, and for my baby. Amen. You know, I remember a time where I could not sit back and say, this is my partner, this is my husband, this is who God has brought into my life. Couldn't do that before because of the fact they looked for first ladies. But I thank God for the first gentleman, not only of my life, but Jurisdiction 4, none other than Mr. Willie Hinton. I'd like for you for a moment to read into your hearing our Bible affirmation. This was given to us by the Reverend Dr. Jamie Washington, who has been an instrument in my life. Let us read it. It says, this is my Bible. It contains basic instructions before leaving Earth. It is a primary resource in the development of my relationship with God. While I believe it's inspired by God, it is not God. It is not to be used as a weapon, but as an instrument of liberation and life. I will pray over it as I study it, and I will interpret it through the Holy Spirit within. My heart is open. Oh, I have the right to question it. I've been told before that this is the infallible word of God. You can't question it. But I thank God for this is a way we can question and put it under the microscope and begin to understand even more of what God is saying to us. So I can question it as I apply its teaching to my life. My heart is open, my mind is alert, and I am ready to praise and to serve the Lord. Is that all right? And our text today, it's coming from Habakkuk 2:2. And it says, And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain unto tables, that they may run that readeth it. My subject today is write the vision. Let us pray. Eternal and all-wise eternal God, we come to you because we know, God, that thou art able to do exceedingly abundantly than what we can ask, imagine, and believe in our hearts. We thank you for this opportunity to come and to break bread with my brothers and sisters virtually. We know, God, that thou art present right now wherever we are, you are. We ask, God, that you be so kind, so just, and so merciful to help move me out of the way, and above all, God, allow your word to fill and to feast of your people. We know, God, if we would just open our minds and our hearts, God, you will fill us up. And for this, we say thank you, thank you, thank you. Amen. We all have visions. We all have times and where we have dreams in our life. You know, some of us want bigger apartments. Some of us want a better car, something better than the push-pull mobiles. I always call it that because we have to push it where we're going, and we have AAA to have to pull it back home. But we want better houses. We want better cars. We want to move out of our apartments into our own house with the white picket fence and the two-car garage. We want to have all of the luxuries of life. So we then look for in our vision, in our dreams, what we want God to do for us. Some of our dreams, some of our visions are small, but some of them are so huge. Some of them are so big, we just don't know whether God can or God will be able to take care of it. But I come to tell you that God, there is nothing so big that God cannot handle it. So no matter how big and no matter how small it is, the only important thing that we have to realize is we have to set realistic goals in how we're going to achieve our vision. No matter how long it takes, it may take a week, it may take a month, it may even take a year, but don't give up hope. Don't become discouraged, because all things will come a pass in its time. Jesus, the great visionary, always referred to God and himself as one. He recognized that God's spirit being not only with him, but in him. And just as Jesus has given us through the power of God, the power and war that we need to be able to transform not just the world, but to transform ourselves. The thing that we have to believe and understand is that we have the power within us to control our destiny. We can do something about where we are and where we are headed. It's an hour in us that we can take the power that God has given unto us, and we can see God work a miracle in our life. What we need to do is we can begin to imagine, to think about the plans for our future. What do we need to do to reach that area in our life that we have dreamed and we see that is the vision for where we want to go? Our vision requires to have an imagination and the wisdom to be able to work our plan. We can't get wherever we want to go by just sitting back and hoping it's going to come our way. What we've got to do is we've got to have a plan to be able to know where we are going. It's bad to get into a car and get driving and don't know where you're going. You have got to have a plan and the destination of where you're planning to go. It is our vision that is going to help to change the world. But it starts with us. The only thing we have control of is ourselves. It's not what other people may say, what other people may say, what box they may want to put us in. The reality is how we show up in the world. Because it's our choice to be a blessing, to be a light to the world, so that they can see a greater light, and that's Christ. We've got to be proactive. We be proactive mean that we are required to be authentic. We cannot be conformed to the things of this world and to the things that, you know, one of the things that I've learned is you can't take a round peg and put it into a square hole. So why are we trying to fit into something that we're not? I thank God for the fact that I came out of churches that said to me, I had to live one way in order to be able to see God. I remember when they used to say to me before I could take communion, have I committed a sin? Have I walked against God? And because of that, many times I did not go up for communion. But I thank God because I realized and found out that God has outstretched arms welcoming everybody to the table. All we got to do is be willing to go. If we do these things, we can prepare ourselves to become the watchperson on the wall. We can prepare ourselves to receive the vision that God has for us, the vision in which God has written across our hearts, that we will be able to stand in the time of trouble. We are charged to write into other people the vision and what God has given unto us. We can either write it or we can read it, but whatever we do, we must make sure that people hear what God has laid into our presence. In our text, the prophet saw himself as a watchman on the wall, working, waiting in anticipation for the liberated word from God. The word that he was going to share with the people. God told him to write the vision, write what I am going to reveal to you, write it down and make it plain, make it large, make it legible, make it so that no matter who comes by, they'll be able to read it and they can run and tell somebody about the fulfillment of God's creation. It is that time where we got to live and walk in the vision in which God has given us. It may not come as soon as we want, but when it comes, it will not be silent. It shall speak. Speak loud, and it will speak clear to us, to let us know that everything, no matter how long it may take, if we hold on, everything is going to work in our favor. Being proactive, children, church, we must hear visions. We must see what God has for us. We must write what God has told us to and what God is speaking to our hearts, that we may be able to encourage somebody. I want you to know sometimes we may think that only thing we're going to get to be able to be inspired is in the Word of God. But I learned sometimes that we can be inspired by a song. And it don't always have to be a religious song. It could be a song by Patti LaBelle. It could be a song by the Jackson Five. It could be a song that resonate within you to let you know that everything is what it is and that God is in the midst of it all. We have got to go beyond seeing God in just the 66 books of the Bible and realize that God is bigger, and we need to see God anew. We are in a time, for this is such a time that we are called. Over 30 years ago, our Archbishop was given a vision, and he took and he wrote it down. And in it, he said, God is love, and love is for everyone. That has stuck in our hearts, that has been with us, and we have gone out and we told the world, those that were oppressed, those that felt as though they didn't have a way of escape, they felt as because people have oppressed them and kept them down, that they had to be what folks have told them, a filthy rags. But I come to tell you that we're not that. Just because of who we're in love with, that does not mean that we are not a child of God. We must believe in the vision that we have in ourselves. We may be inspired by so many things. It could be a bulletin board. It could be an affirmation that has been written that we read. But we have to take and write it down. We a lot of times have sayings that we've heard that we can put on a post-it note, put it up on the refrigerator, put it up on the mirror, in the bathroom, someplace where you can read it and be able to be encouraged and go out and tell somebody how wonderful your day is. Have you ever ran into that person where you asked them, how was your day? And they always had an excuse about how bad things are or how they wish things could be better. Know within yourself that you have the power to change it because your words have power, and what you send out will come rolling back to you with everything that have been negative that you sent out. It will all pile up together and come back, but you need to release that negative energy and move forward in life. Visions are of our future. It takes time to materialize, but I want you to know that you have to wait. Don't lose hope. Don't let go. Don't be disencouraged, but just hold on and know that in its due season, it will certainly come. Ecclesiastic 3:1 says, to everything, there is a season, a time for every purpose under the sun. Guess what, y'all? It's our season. It's our time, it's our season to receive what God has given to us, what God has called us to do. Now is the time. Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes wrote a song, and it says very simple, wake up everybody. No more sleeping in bed. No more backward thinking, but think ahead. We've got to begin to get up and do something about the situations in our life in order to be able to be a help and a blessing to somebody else. The worst thing that can happen is somebody who is not in a relationship or in their 20th relationship to advise us of a relationship. Don't tell somebody how to live a relationship when you have no understanding about it yourself. We have folks out here now that want to be counselors with their crackerjack diploma. But what we need to do is we need to recognize the who is in the front rows of our life. Who have we invited there that is sitting in the very front rows of our life? Who is it that is there that's talking the negative, that's pointing the fingers? Those that we have invited in, some of them should have been in the back row, some of them should have been in the balcony, and some of them should not have been in the theater of your life. Bishop Hollins made a statement a few convocations back, where she said, we are the movement. when you make a statement that is such an affirming statement, people will pick it up. It was on Facebook. It was in Twitter. People made signs across in their on t-shirts. They're saying, we are the movement. That's how powerful it is when you put out an affirmation. So what we got to do is we've got to see our vision. We got to hold on to our vision. But the only thing is once we have received it, once we understand it, once we have put it out there, we have got to write it. We've got to let people know just where we stand, knowing that I realize in me that I am not Archbishop Carl Bing. I am not Senior Bishop Jones. I am not Bishop Holland. Who I am is what God has made me to be. I don't try to preach like anybody else. I am who I am, who I am. So for that reason, I tell you today, know your purpose in life. Look into yourself and be able to find where that written across your heart, that word, that vision, that statement that you will be able to look at and be able to know and realize that God has put something in you. Yours may not be like mine. Mine may not be like yours. But whatever you have in you, know that God has prepared you for such a time as this. God has uplifted you for you to be a light on the hillside. That will let somebody know and understand that everything is going to be all right, because God loves them just as God has created them to be. Know and understand that no matter what come, what go, you don't have to fit into nobody's box for yourself. But what you need to do is be authentic, be who you are, be and walk in your power, walk in your divinity, and know that God is on your side. God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above that we can ask. Trust in the Lord, thy God. And then write the vision. Write it on your heart. Write it in your spirit. Write it on paper. But make sure you write it in a way that people will be able to read it, be able to hear it, no matter what come, what go. Write it, read it, sign it, so that everybody will be able to and connect to the vision. When they connect to the vision, they'll be able to read it, they'll hear it, and they'll run on and tell somebody. Ain't it good to know that you have given something to somebody, amen, just like Bishop Hollins, that somebody will take it and run with it. They will take it to somebody else and let them know that God loves them just the way they are. That's why I see slogans, and I see that there's a lot of folk that put their signs across their chest that say, God loves you, and so do I. This is the time, church, that we must live up to our calling, because there are so many people out here that is on the wayside that don't know how and what way to go. But I know that 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 we are going to make it, huh? Because no matter what come and no matter what go, I tell you that the God that I serve, the God that I believe in, the God that is able to do exceedingly and abundantly, I can trust in that God, no matter how it looks sometimes. I realize it may look like it's dark outside, but the God I serve will bring forth a light on the inside. It may look like I'm not going to be able to make it, but if I read inside of me, if I reach down on the inside, I'll feel and be able to connect with the vision that God has placed in me. And when I reach and I connect with that vision, I'll be able to run like there's no tomorrow. I'll be able to fight like I'm a winner. Where I can stand when I feel like I'm going to fall. I can do because God said I can do it. I am who God says that I am. Trust, believe, and know that God has given you a vision. is the vision of the right now, and it's a vision of the future. Know that what God has placed in you is more than what anybody else may be able to see, but it's there. Believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Believe that you can make a change starting with you. And if you can change the inside of you, getting away all of the pain and the hatred that you had for yourself, and be able to walk in your truth. Movement, I want you to know that as we are celebrating our 2020 Holy Convocation, know that everything for us is going to be our action to do something in this world. If we're going to be proactive, then what we got to do is get involved. We got to get folks out to vote like never before. You may have to pick somebody up and take them to the polling booth, but do what you need to do to be a blessing to somebody. I know you can, and I believe you will, because we are called to be proactive. God bless you. May heaven smile on you and take you to the next level of your vision. Amen, amen, and amen. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Woo. Amen. 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 Thank you, Bishop. What a word. What a word. Woo. Connect with the vision on your heart. I don't know about y'all, but I am full. It went straight to my heart. That message is a message that I will carry on. Oh, my goodness. And this is just the first day of convocation. This is just our first night of worship. We have three more to go. And before I give you a little bit about what's coming the next few days, I want to remind you that the giving link is still on Facebook. It's pinned on Facebook. As Elder Washington said, we need to raise $2,000 a night. So if you have not given already, please look for that link on Facebook and YouTube. And it's showing. And if you, that's on realm.org/UFC movement/give/offering. And I thank you in advance for that. So convocation does not end until Sunday afternoon. And so we do not, as a tradition, end in prayer. We just keep going every day until it's over. So I just want to remind you of a few things to come. First of all, please check your emails. Check your emails, because the people that registered your emails will give you the links and the information that you need to join the workshops that are to come. So tomorrow morning is our new voices. And as we know, those are the people that are being uplifted and ordained, and they will give their sermons. That's Friday morning. And then we will also have another powerful workshop Friday afternoon, and then worship like we're doing tonight again tomorrow evening. And Saturday, get ready for Saturday. Saturday night, before I get to Saturday night, we have a day of workshops as well. We have some workshops and activities for young people. And all of this, you will find the details on your Facebook page, on our Unity Fellowship Holy Convocation Facebook page, and in your emails. But I want to remind you, Saturday night is a night of fun. We worship and we also have fun. So we will have games, we will be dancing, there's going to be a DJ, and we have a fundraiser like we've had for the last 4 or 5 years, the Money Cake. Can you believe it? We're doing a virtual Money Cake. And the link to get the money cake will also be posted. And the winner of the money cake will be announced on Saturday evening. So check your emails, make sure you're registered so that you can get the links for what is to come. And I think that is it for this evening. Thank you all. I forgot I was sitting up in my studio. That's the thing about virtual. We didn't know what was going to happen, but the vision, as the bishop said, the vision of having worship, the vision of doing convocation, the vision of continuing to do what the archbishop has laid in our hearts was on our hearts. And so we sat down and planned it and we did it. And I'm so excited and I hope you are too. And I will see you tomorrow morning. Stay tuned. I believe that there is something that will be after this. We have some vendors and I don't know if we got a chance to do it, but stay tuned after I say goodbye and see what is to come, because there will be a scroll of information. God is good. God is, and so we are. Amen. See you all tomorrow.